Hello everyone, today I am going to start economics subject, economics and managerial economics. So this is one of the very important subject for the commerce and management students and also for non-commerce students like engineering and MCA graduates also, MCA postgraduates, even they have this managerial economics because the need and importance of managerial economics. So first of all, before going to the managerial economics, we must have a small idea about what is economics. Economics plays a vital role in the individual life and progress of the country, progress of the nation, and anywhere, everywhere economics is important. So suppose if I have a salary of say 30,000, so how I can allocate it and where I can invest, how I can save the money and where I can spend it, where I can put my investments. Like this is also economy. This also comes under the economics, and in the same way for the progress of the country and for the progress of industry, everywhere we just take care of this economics. Economics is such an important aspect. So in a short, what we can say about economics, a small definition I'm going to share with you. So economics is the study of how people allocate, their resources and to produce, to consume goods and services, their unlimited wants, with the objectives of maximizing the gain. Every people are having some resources. That resources, how they can allocate it, how they can spend it, that is what they, how people allocate their resources and to produce, to consume the goods and services, their unlimited wants and objects to maximizing the gains. Every human being will have unlimited wants, but resources are less. So with the limited resources, how they can maximize the maximum profit, maximum level utilization. So that is economics. Economics is the base. If we have a proper understanding about economics, then we can go for the managerial economics. In economics, if you see the nature and characteristics or features of any economics, you can say four features, four characteristics. The first one is unlimited wants. Wants are always unlimited. I want this, I want to buy that, and I want to grab this, like unlimited wants. But what do we have when we have wants are unlimited? The second feature is that scarce resources. Our resources are very less. Resources are less, wants are more. A simple example actually. Employee salary is 20,000. This is his resources. And wants are unlimited. Want to buy a house, want to buy a vehicle, and want to go to a hi-fi restaurant, and want to go for tours, like unlimited it is. So when it is unlimited, then how he can allocate it? So related to that we are going to talk. So resources are less, say source resources, and unlimited wants. When resources are less, then what to do? The next feature says alternative use of resources. See the alternative resources. How many resources are there? Say I have this much of money. What I can do? I can buy either flat or either vehicle or either I can go for two, something only. So you have to choose the alternative. A, B, C, D alternatives are there. Which one is suitable? Which one is necessary according to your wants? According to that you have to select it. So the thing is that alternative uses of resources, that you have to select it. How many alternatives are there? Say 1, 2, 3, 4, A, B, C, D. Like we have all these alternatives. Next, what to do? Next one is the choice. What's your choice? When you find that alternatives are this much, what is the right choice? According to the priority, we have to go for the choice. These are the main features or characteristics, or you can say nature of the economics. First one is unlimited wants. Our wants are unlimited, and so scarce resources. Resources are very less, and alternative uses we must know. Then after that, taking a right choice. So this is about economics. And in economics, we can find different kinds of categories like approaches of economics. This is very, very important. How we can approach, how we can go for this economics approaches. We have two kinds of approaches. One is microeconomics, macroeconomics. This is very important aspect. If you are a CS student, ICWA, CS, or even normal graduate students, BCom, MCom, MBA, anyway, even you, if you are a BTech student, so this is very important aspect. microeconomics, macroeconomics, approaches, two approaches. What is this microeconomics? Micro's word is taken from Latin word. So micro means small. Micros means small. So in microeconomics, we'll study about the small things only. Say an individual or a firm, a industry. So individual person is there. He may be a businessman, he is a professional candidate, or maybe doing a job or something. But his economic status, his economic planning, everything is individual. So that you can take, or a small industry. A small industry is there. So that industry also, they wanted to plan about the resources, how we can allocate it, how we can best utilization of the resources, and how we can get the profit, and how we can go for the sales, like all these things, best utilization of individual firm. Individual firm, that is also small one. And a small industry, that is also small one. So like microeconomics talks about a small, small things, small allocation of resources, like an individual, firm, or business, or any industry, but not in large. So the best example which you can say, behavior of individual units. Microeconomics talks about behavior of individual units, such as households, any individual person, firms, or industries. This is microeconomics. Second one is macroeconomics. Macros. The word is taken from macros. This word is taken from Greek word large. It means large. So macroeconomic quite opposite to micro. We'll talk about large. Large economics, large study of any environment, large study of the nation. So anything in large. So not one individual, not about industry, not about any firm, not about any company. So we'll talk about large. Total income of the country, total income of the state, and total educated people in the state, and what are the resources of the total country, and how much we are exporting, how much we are importing, all together in large scale. So it is useful to understand the economy or development or planning of any country in large scale. So here we can set a simple example of national income, or total consumption, total investment, and total employment. Like large scale, when we wanted to plan, when we wanted to get anything, so that is called as macroeconomics. Micro is small, macro is big one. So we'll see now the what is managerial economics. Now coming to the managerial economics. Economics is, we have some idea what is economics. Now managerial economics, which is useful, which is helpful for the management. How we can define this managerial economics? Small definition I'm giving you. The managerial economics is the integration of economic theory. So based on the economic theory, integration of economic theory with business practice for the purpose of facilitating decision making. So it's basic of economic theory for the purpose of facilitating decision making and forward planning by the management. So by using this economic theory, which is useful for the management in decision making and also managerial workouts, and how we can work out the things like understanding the basic principles of economics, like what is demand, supply, and pricing decisions, production, and all these things, all the theories of managerial economics, that is, which is helpful for the management. So that we'll call it as a managerial economics. So managerial economics is quite vast, and it is much important even for the non-science students also, non-commerce students and non-science, anyone, everyone it is required. So what is this managerial economics? A simple formula I tell you. Managerial economics is equal to nothing but economics plus decision science, economics plus decision science plus business management for the management purpose. So taking the economics, basic principles of economics, decision making, and also which is useful for the business management. Why we are saying managerial economics, which is useful for the management, why we are saying? Most of the time management, If you take a production department or software industry, most of the management, high level people, they won't be having much knowledge about this economics. So by using this economics, giving them an idea, giving them kind of suggestions like what we can do. So that is what suggestions for the management. So that's called as managerial economics. If you see the characteristics or nature of managerial economics, 8 characteristics are there. The first one is microeconomics in character. Managerial economics is always in microeconomics. What is micro? Small. Study of small. Maybe individual or industry or a firm or a business. For this purpose, managerial economics, we are using it. Either for individual, business or any kind of industry. For that purpose. Microeconomics, nature is micro. So the managerial economics is not going to study about, not going to talk about the macroeconomics. Macro is not much, but very rarely we just go even for the macroeconomics. For this, a depth of knowledge in economics which is required, otherwise not possible. So by the nature it is microeconomics. And normative science. Normative science, why we are saying is economics, this managerial economics says that what to do. What are the decisions to be taken? What is the action to be taken within the sources? So it says, it gives the suggestions. Like a small example I'll tell you. Suppose we have a business to buy the product or to make the product. Sometimes most of the organizations, they are directly buying the products and labeling, or otherwise they are preparing some other things by purchasing raw material, by purchasing products directly, and they'll be modifying and giving the name brand of their organization and selling it. So that's called as buy or make. Make means shall be prepared by ourselves. It's a small example I have given you. Like many things are there in managerial economics. Make or buy decisions. Who has to do? So here normative science says that what to do. And what is the decision to be taken? Shall we buy or shall we make? If we buy, what will be the cost? If we purchase and if we prepare, what will be the cost? Like, it gives the clarity. That's why we say it as a normative science. What is to be done is going to tell you the managerial economics. Then after that, prescriptive rather than descriptive. So it's always prescriptive. Rather the descriptive means it describes about the policies, rules and regulations. It's quite prescriptive means what is the action to be taken, what are the suggestions to be done. Like for example, we have to fix up the prices. To fix up the prices, what do we have the knowledge? So pricing strategies and in the market pricing strategies and alternative the companies, alternative products, what is the pricing strategy of those alternative products, like we need to have much knowledge. So when we have knowledge, then only we can go. So here it says that prescriptive. So this is what you have to do, understand it and get the knowledge, then after that you can go ahead. So like prescriptive, giving the suggestions what to do and what action to be taken, how you have to go ahead within the resources, within the limited resources. So profit-oriented point of view, sales, purchases, demand, supply, and all these things are related to prescriptive, not just descriptive. Descriptive is only it will give you idea, but prescriptive is it's going to give you the suggestions. So that is why managerial economics always prescriptive rather than the descriptive. And a scientific art we are saying. So why scientific art? It's an art, managerial economics. Yes, we have lot of theories, we have lot of concepts. All these concepts, if we understand in a proper way, according to the need, according to the decision, according to the situation, then only you can utilize. So it's like an art of utilizing it and giving suggestions to the proper person in a right way. Like example you can take, we must understand about the supply, demand, and what is break-even analysis, and what is production theory, market strategies. All these things, having knowledge is not enough, just applying the knowledge into proper way. That's an art. So that is why we say managerial economics as an art. Then after that, utilizes some of the theories of macroeconomics also. Few theories also we are going to use from the macroeconomics. Macroeconomics is large. It comes in a later stage. Who's having a very vast knowledge, good depth knowledge about this economics, then only they can go for this macroeconomics. So this here we have some formulas, we have some strategies for macroeconomics understanding and application. So that also to some extent managerial economics is going to helpful. But in the same way, goal oriented and problem solving in nature. Managerial economics always says that what are the company's ambitions, goals and aims. So based on this, how you can achieve your goals. So how you can achieve your goals, that is also going to give you an idea by the managerial economics. Simple example I'll tell you. Suppose your ambition or your aim is to reach the sales of say 1 crore rupees of sales you wanted to reach. If you want to reach through the 1 crore sales, what should be the profit? Or if you want to have a profit of 2 crores, what should be the sales? Want to have a profit of 2 crores and what should be the sales? Like a different concepts, it's going to give you a simple example only I have given you. Like many things are there problem oriented. So what is your goal? What is your ambition? According to that, what is to be done? So based on that, we'll have a lot of talks. And integrates theory into practice. Integrates the theory into practice, simply not giving the theory. So this theory, different kinds of theories, all these theories are practical approach oriented only. Suppose say if we study about markets, we have different kinds of markets. Monopoly market, perfect market, imperfect market. So like different markets are there. So different markets are having different kinds of features. Not just theory, it's not going to give you the theory. So practical approach. If it is a monopoly market, then what should be the pricing strategy? If it is perfect market, then what is to be done? So like everything is practical oriented, not just theory oriented. So and applications of economics, it uses the basics of economics, application of economics. So how we can use the basics of economics? Simple. In economics, we'll be studying about mainly the market strategies, demand, supply, production, pricing strategies, and break-even analysis, and all this. The basics of this, we are going to use it, and after using it, so the ultimately the result should be what is to be useful for the management. How the theory, how these practical problems or practical theory problems and all these things, how it is going to useful for the management. In that way it is going to work out. That is why we say it as applications of economics. We take the applications of economics, but that economic applications, we just turn it, we just give in a suggestion form or suggestion form to the management so that they can take the decisions in a proper way. So these are the main characteristics of any managerial economics. In the coming classes, I'm going to talk about nature and scope of managerial economics and demand analysis, supply analysis, and how we can go ahead, all these things. I'm going to talk in depth. Hope the talk is useful. So study well, practice well. Wish you good luck. Keep smiling, keep shining.